For the past 2 months, I have been out walking and knocking doors for two of my friends that are running for the school board. I have literally talked to hundreds of people. And what I have found is that they are just like me. They have so many concerns, they're frustrated, and they're simply baffled. I would like to share, in no particular order, a few of these comments that I have received. One parent, JC, said, "I can't send a cough drop to school with my kid, but they can let my kid leave school to get an abortion or a sex change and not let me know about it. What happens if my daughter gets an abortion and that night she spikes a fever, has some kind of infection, hemorrhages, etc., and I don't know because I was not told? Or what if she dies during the night because no one checked on her because we didn't know? Or she's hospitalized for a week? Who's going to pay for that? Are they going to pay for the therapy later if she regrets her decision? I had to sign a paper for my senior daughter to get permission to leave the campus for lunch. But yet she can go and do whatever she wants and get an abortion or a sex change without me knowing. I have to sign a paper for a field trip. I have to sign a paper for my child to watch a movie at school. What is going on in this state? It is horrifying. I work at two surgical centers as a nurse. If we have somebody under 18 years old, whether they are there for tonsils, a broken wrist, hernia, tubes in their ears, whatever it is, I have to have a parent consent. And that is nothing compared to an abortion and not knowing about it. I would hope that you guys can see that this is a concern of many parents. I had a parent tell me, if you have kids in sports, especially varsity sports, weekday games are so late, and because school is so late, they have no time to do their homework until almost midnight. Another, J.O., said, "My daughter's in color guard and band. She comes home from school for an hour, then goes back to practice till 9:30. I hate the 30 minutes that was added. It does not make up for anything. Where are our priorities? It's not on education." There was a 1995 Parent Act that said you need to protect the rights of parents upbringing their kids.
Oscar Avila, followed by Michael Sherman,